Hello students, myself Abhishek Arora, and today we are going to discuss about how we solve a particular limit. In our previous video, you must have seen how we have discussed about the concept of the limits, that what are basic limits and how the algebra of the limits work. Today we are going to discuss by taking a few illustrations that how we apply those limits in a particular question. Okay. So now if you see, the first thing that we need to understand about solving a basic limit is, but that is a substitution method. That's the most basic method that we use for solving a particular question that is related to your limits. For the same, what happens is, as the name itself suggests, that it is a substitution method. So basically what you have to do is, you have to take the limit and substitute it in a particular function, right? आपके पास एक लिमिट दी होगी, आपको उसको एक पर्टिकुलर फंक्शन में उसकी वैल्यू को सब्स्टिट्यूट कर देना है और हमारे पास एक पर्टिकुलर आंसर आ जाएगा. सो फॉर द सेम, लेट अस टेक अ इलस्ट्रेशन हियर. दैट व्हाट आई हैव टेकन हियर इज दैट इज देयर इज अ बेसिक लिमिट. ओके, वी आर अप्रोचिंग, एक्स इज अप्रोचिंग द लिमिट 2 एंड देयर इज दिस फंक्शन एक्स स्क्वायर प्लस 4 अपॉन एक्स प्लस 2. ओके, व्हाट वी आर डूइंग इज वी आर नॉट गोइंग टू सब्स्टिट्यूट एनी नंबर विच इज वेरी वेरी क्लोज टू 2 हियर. ओके, as we had already discussed what is a basic limit. Hum yahan pe koi 1.9999 value ya 2.0001 value isko substitute nahi karenge. Okay, we'll be taking the same number, that is x, which is approaching towards. Okay, jahan pe x aapka approach kar raha hai jis number ki taraf, usi number ko hum yahan pe substitute kar denge, because basically 1.9999 is very very close to 2. So we take the approximate value and substitute in the function. Okay, so if you see here, what we have done here is, I directly took the number 2 and substituted here. Okay, so that is your 2 square. Wherever we find x, we have substituted the value there. Okay, so if you see, there is 2 square plus 4, and in the denominator it is 2 plus 2. Okay, so your particular answer is 8 by 4, that is 2. Okay, so that is how we solve a very basic limit, that you have a question, you just have to take the value of x and substitute it there. Okay, let's move on to the second type of these questions. These are obviously very easy ones, but the second type is your indeterminate forms. Indeterminate forms, what are such forms? I take the illustration and then we'll discuss what kind of forms are these. Okay, suppose I've taken such question. There is this, these are two functions, that is f of x and g of x. There are two kind of functions, and I am taking a limit, okay, that is x approaching 1 in this case, and I have taking I have taken the division of these two functions. Let us substitute the value 1 in this case. Now if you see, when we have substituted the value, the answer becomes 0 by 0. Okay, 0 by 0 form, this is the indeterminate form. Whenever we find such kind of problems where we are having a 0 by 0 form, infinity to the power infinity, or infinity by infinity, infinity minus infinity, all such problems will be considered in the indeterminate form. Okay, so if we are taking all such, exactly all such problems that we are taking, infinity upon infinity, then 0 to the power 0, 0 upon 0, all such forms, whenever we encounter in limits, we always have a few steps to follow to solve such particular questions. Okay, like for solving 0 by 0 form, what we are taking, the first method of evaluation here is your factorization method. Okay, for the same, let us again take an illustration. Okay, you will be getting my point how we basically solve this by using the illustration itself. Now, if you see, there is this function, I have taken your limit x approaching 2, x square minus 4 upon x minus 2. Okay. Now, if you see, what I have done is, I take the number 2 and substitute it in x. What happens? It's 2 square minus 4 upon 2 minus 2. That is 4 minus 4 upon 2 minus 2, 0 upon 0. You get the 0 by 0 form. Okay. So, to solve 0 by 0 form, what we do is, we first thing that we need to do is the factorization. Let us take the factors of the numerator part. If you see, x square minus 4, 4 means 2 square. That means x square minus 2 square, a square minus b square, right? What we can write it as, ए स्क्वायर माइनस बी स्क्वायर ए माइनस बी ए प्लस बी अपॉन ए जो वट एवर एक्स माइनस टू वी आर हैविंग. सो इफ यू सी नाउ वी कैन डिलीट एक्स माइनस टू फ्रॉम द न्यूमिनेटर एंड द डिनोमिनेटर एंड वट वी आर लेफ्ट विद दिस एक्स प्लस टू. फाइन. नाउ इफ यू सब्सटीट्यूट द लिमिट राइट नाउ ओके वट हैपन्स यू विल बी सब्सटीट्यूटिंग द वैल्यू ऑफ एक्स एज टू. नाउ द आंसर इज टू प्लस टू दैट इज इक्वल टू फोर राइट. सो दैट इज फैक्टराइजेशन मेथड बेसिकली मीन्स whenever we are using the factorization method we always have to take the factors of the numerator or the denominator we cancel all the parts and then substitute the limit you'll be eliminating the 0 by 0 form by the same okay. So this is the first type of thing that we encounter whenever we have a 0 by 0 form okay. We can use the factorization method and then solve it. This is the second type of thing that we can do, that is your rationalization method. For rationalization method, what we can do is, again, see, we'll be encountering a few questions where we'll be getting 0 by 0 form, but all those questions cannot only be solved by factorization method. So there is this another method, that is your rationalization method. In this method, what we have is, we always be having a third, okay, in this case, I have a root function, that is root of x plus 5, okay, minus 3 upon x minus 4. And there is this x which is approaching 4. Now, what happens, that is, if we substitute the value of x equivalent to 4, what happens? Again, root of 9 minus 3 upon 4 minus 4. You get the 0 by 0 form. But 0 by 0 form is not applicable in your limits. Now, how to solve such questions? For all these problems, wherever we'll be having a third, we can use the rationalization method. Okay? Now, if you see, I rationalize my numerator, okay? If I rationalize my numerator, what happens? We can multiply and divide by changing the sign as we usually do in the rationalization, okay? Then, after rationalization, if I substitute all these limits, you see, again, the cancellation is being done. In the numerator, in the denominator, x minus 4, we delete both of them and then substitute the value of the function, that is, x is equal to 4. Then the answer, if you see, here is 1 by 6. So this is how we are encountering. If you see, in both the questions, there was 0 by 0 form. In the first question, there was the factorization. The factors can be made from the numerator or the denominator. Again, the cancellations were done. In the second method, if you see the rationalization method, there was this third which we were having. And after that, we rationalized that third again. You got one particular function which was getting cancelled out, and then whatever we were left with, we substituted the value there, you got your particular answer. So for these 0 by 0 form, there are two basic methods which we can use, okay? There is this another method, that is L'Hopital method, okay? The spelling is L'Hospital, but it is stated as L'Hopital, okay? The L'Hopital rule basically states that you have to take the differentiation. But one thing, the same question which he is asking, that is u by v rule of differentiation, that will not be used. It will not be used here. Okay. This L'Hopital rule, again, I'm taking an illustration to make sure that you understand the concept easily. What I'm taking is, if you see limit x approaching 0, sine x upon x, I have to prove that it is equal to 1. If you take the value of x and substitute it in the function, we get sine 0 upon 0. Again, 0 by 0 form. What we can do? We can use the factorization method, but factors of this cannot be taken. Again, we can use the rationalization method, but there is no third. We cannot take that. There is this method, that is your L'Hopital rule. L'Hopital rule states that you can take the differentiation of the numerator, you can take the differentiation of the denominator separately, not by using the u by v rule. न्यूमिनेटर का आपने डिफरेंशिएशन कर दिया, डिनोमिनेटर का आपने डिफरेंशिएशन कर दिया, उसके बाद आप इस लिमिट को सब्सटीट्यूट कर दें, ओके? सी, आई हैव डन इट हियर. व्हाट आई हैव डन इज, आई हैव टेकन द डिफरेंशिएशन ऑफ द न्यूमिनेटर, दैट इज साइन एक्स का आपके पास कॉस एक्स आ गया, और नीचे जो फंक्शन था दैट इज योर एक्स, आई हैव टेकन द डिफरेंशिएशन ऑफ द सेम. व्हाट हैपेंस, द एक्स का डिफरेंशिएशन बिकम्स 1, ओके? सो यू आर लेफ्ट विद द फंक्शन लिमिट एक्स अप्रोचिंग 0 कॉस ऑफ एक्स अपॉन 1. Now, if I substitute the value of x equivalent to 0, that is cos of 0, that is equal to what? that is equivalent to 1, right? So that is the particular answer of the same. Now if you see, there is this very easy formula that we can do, we can use, that is the L'Hopital thing. It is the simplest form which we can use whenever we encounter 0 by 0 form. So basically today what we have learnt about is how we are solving the 0 by 0 form. That is by particular three methods, that is either by factorization or by rationalization or the L'Hopital rule. But just remember, whenever we are talking about L'Hopital, you need not take U by V rule. You will always have to take the differentiation of the numerator, the differentiation of the denominator, and then solve it. Okay. So if you like the video, please subscribe and stay tuned.